Okay guys, I just wanted to do a quick video on these forks I finished rebuilding. Got them free from a buddy of mine. He had a custom back frame for his tractor because this is a Ford. Just he used the Ford attachment points, and I got the skidsteer quick attach now. So what I did to make it as light as humanly possible, and actually could get a little bit more weight off it yet, I used just a heavy duty skid plate or skid steer plate, back plate. This one's a quarter inch all over. And this is the same plate I bolted my, that's my mount for my snowplow blade. Happens to be almost the right size in the middle for the spacing of pallets. It keeps the pallets just the right apart for lifting most pallets, because I've tried on several so far and haven't had an issue. But yeah, anyhow, I cut off his mount points for the rod. All they have is a heavy duty rod on the top. That's 1 inch diameter. No idea if it's cold rolled or hot rolled or what. I would say whatever's stronger. It doesn't bend, or it hasn't. So that goes all the way across and just goes through these. These are thicker than a quarter. They're close to 3/8. They're between a quarter and 3/8 inch tabs. I would think a quarter would be fine. Anyhow, I got one welded on the outside here. And same thing on the other. And then I have two in the center there welded on. They just have that top plate because when I cut them off the other piece to keep them together, I just... that's just tacked on the top. I might cut it off yet if it's in the way for my chain for plowing in the winter. I don't think it will be, but I just left it on. Anyhow, so you just have this bar going through, and then the top of the uprights of the forks is just a piece of pipe, basically. Round tube, I guess, maybe. You buy it that way at the metal place? I don't know. Probably. Never bought round tube like that. But that's good thickness too. That's about, I think that's quarter. Yeah, it's probably quarter wall. And then the old upright on this side I had to replace because this is what happened to it. My buddy said he did something stupid. I'm not sure what he did, but whatever he did, pretzeled that sucker. So that was the upright. The other one still has that style. And this is quarter inch channel. But yeah, he twisted the heck out of it. So I figured when I rebuilt it, I would upgrade it. And I'm using tubular. I'm actually using 1/8 inch. Because I didn't have any quarter, and 1/8 inch is way cheaper. I think 1/8 inch is probably plenty, but we'll see in the long term. I have already picked up over 1,000 pounds with this. Max loader capacity, I couldn't even get halfway up. Hopefully doing some sketchy shit. So there's your upright. Probably do quarter inch if you get it for a reasonable price. Otherwise, 1/8 inch seems to be holding. Yeah, so anyhow, I reused these braces on the side. It's interesting. I don't know if that's actual fork material or if it's just that channel and he welded it shut. It must be forks. Oops. Because it's heavier than the channel, I think. But anyhow, I mean, it looks home welded or something. But I don't know. Not sure. But if you could get forks or use heavy channel, I would say actually use heavy tubular. Just cut the angle at the end, it'd be a lot stronger. For our little tractors, you know, 1,000 pounds all we can really lift, if that. So yeah, it's really simple and it works. And you got full adjustment if I took off the mount for the snowplow, you'd have full adjustment, you know, but when would you ever need to pick up something that's that skinny? And it'd be tippy then. So I don't see why that would be in the way. If it is, it's 4 bolts to take off. Not a big deal. But yeah, that's my super lightweight
skidsteer mount pallet forks.